are back for day two on the house demo. I'm going to load up the rest of this concrete. Maybe when Dad gets back over here. Yeah, we just got these pieces. I need to bust up this floor. And then I got to try to see if I can bust up the front porch and steps that were on this house. That's a pretty big chunk over there, so... push the rain off until I think this evening sometime, so we're gonna try to get all this concrete out, kind of get this one rough graded, and then may see if we can start tearing the roof and stuff off that other house and get that to the dump before everything gets too wet and muddy. I don't know if we'll be able to get to any concrete on that house, so then our field access will kind of be out for the rest of this week. When I try to get all these busted up just as small as I can, so it is a little easier on the truck. We got a little trash mixed in with it, but it'll be all right. It's like super windy out here again. Right, it's like a constant 35-40 mile an hour wind with even more gusts. Because right now it's like 60, but it's supposed to start raining and then turn to sleet and snow over the evening time. And then tomorrow the high is only like maybe 30, and then it gets down to like 15. So. But then Friday, we're back up to like 49 or 50. Man, while this was warming up, I was greasing in. I had a real nice chat with a guy named Ron that he actually lives around here and works for the county. He was running a John Deere motor grader. I think it was a 672G, I believe. So he was cruising by and then pulled on in here. That was kind of neat. He says he watches my videos and thought he was going to run into me one of them someday around here. So to me, that is the best part of the YouTube stuff, is just the people I get to meet. I always enjoy running into people that either watch my videos or they kind of do similar work and get a visit with them. So yeah, we had a nice chat with him. He was running down, I think he's got 30 miles of gravel roads out in this county that he maintains. So but that was pretty cool. So that kind of stuff, I don't know, like I said, I always enjoy getting to meet everybody and hearing about what they do and what they enjoy and stuff, so that was cool. Try to carefully set the concrete in the truck. I try to kind of take my time on this part of it, just because instead of just grabbing huge bucket fulls, it's just almost easier to get a couple pieces and I can set them in there. I kind of get a good base of them on the bottom, then you can usually grab a little more. Just, it's a little easier on the truck. Especially he's got one of those liners. His liner's actually in pretty good shape in the back of his truck, so I try to keep it that way. It's just hard on stuff all around. I mean, it's on the equipment, trying to rip it out, and then it's tough on dump truck beds and tailgates and everything else. I'm gonna actually, for now, leave this concrete pad that I'm setting on, because they asked me about leaving it intact if I thought it was gonna be good enough. Probably just try to keep it here for them. That way they can, they got like a kind of like I said, a dry spot to park when it's muddy or wet and stuff out here. And it's not in the best shape, but if they're gonna, you know, park a truck or a trailer or motorhome or anything like that on there, it'll do just fine for that. We'll bring in a little bit of fill and some dirt and put back in where the house was at, and we're just gonna see. We may blow straw on not anytime soon, because this is like being out in Kansas out here. There's not much of a wind barrier, so it's like it's windy in town. You get out here and it's really windy, so there's not a lot of point to put any straw out right now. I'll get over here later on, maybe with Dad's loader, and kind of slick it up a little bit more. Then we'll have to just start bringing in a little bit of fill dirt and actual dirt. that kind of at least gets it somewhat flattened out and tracked in. I forgot a little bit of the sidewalk to haul off there, and I'm going to have them look at that patch. They asked about keeping it, so I bet we take it out because it's in pretty rough shape. But that's where we're at with this house. I'm going to go down there and help them move some of that concrete, and then see about starting on the other one. Here is house number two. And I'm not sure, this one could be, I don't know, to toss up on which one's in worse shape. The roof is definitely shot, and I think most of the floor inside. This one's got a small basement, but this is like old school, I guess I'd call it stucco still, but it's like concrete, and they put like expanded metal on the outside, and then put, I guess it's a type of concrete or more, I don't know. I'm sure somebody on here will know more about it than I do, but yeah, the roof is actually rotten where the roof joists and stuff are at. They're just gone. But so this one will probably have a little bit less lumber. I don't know, like I said, I've never tore one of these apart. It could have wood on the inside of there too, but I know the interior walls and the roof and such, and probably the floor, looks like the heater and stuff is underneath the house. And then I think this is the old septic tank I gotta smash in and fill in. And then I think we'll have a little bit of metal. We'll pull it off there, and Dak can bring down his grapple and haul that back to the scrap pile. But yeah, this house has seen better days. Well, we're getting a little bit of rain in here, but I'm gonna try to get as much of the roof and the wood. Maybe we can get, I don't know, a couple trips out of here to the dump, and then just kind of get it smashed up, and we'll see what weather we're gonna get. I don't know if we'll have time to start hauling any concrete over to our spot, but I should be able to get the roof and the back porch and all that stuff off of here. Ooh, we got like a Bowflex in here. I may have to. Ooh, yeah, the floor. May not walk in here too much further. I'm gonna have to take that home to Miss Elite. Have some exercise equipment there. Got a nice little divan. Yeah, the roof is, I can feel the floor just like. Yeah, I'd say it's time. Yeah, that may be, just concrete walls. This thing is shot. Yeah, we're gonna have a lot more concrete on this one to haul off. Let's get to it. Thank you.
be my stopping point for this evening. So the dump's closed and I kind of tried to get everything just smashed up. I went ahead and just knocked those walls in there because they were a little bit iffy on if they were going to stand up or not. So now I've just got a royal mess, and you can tell it's like really, really soft over here because the excavator's sinking, but I kind of smashed it down. We'll see what this weather does tonight and tomorrow, if we'll be back, or it may have to be next week or whatever by the time it dries out enough. But yeah, it's like a bomb went off down here, but it didn't take long to get this house down, so it came apart pretty easy. So I just gotta smash it up a little better and dig it all out of the basement. So we'll just check in with you guys tomorrow.